Hi and welcome to the channel. Today I will be showing you everything you need to know about images in Word. How to insert them, how to crop them, how to move them, how to crop them to a shape, how to align them, and how to do some customization. So the first thing is to go up to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down. So you can search from your browser, you can search from your files on your computer, or there are some stock images or some online pictures as well. So these are really the two that you might want to be concerned with. So obviously your picture from file, if you click on that, and then you can go ahead and select a picture of your choice. Let's select this one and then go down and click Insert. Or you can go to Insert, Pictures, click on the drop down. If you go to Stock Images, then Word has got some images within the software, and you can scroll down and look for an appropriate image, or at the top here you can simply type in a theme and then you can scroll through that particular theme and pick an image of your choice. Once you do, just select it and then just go down and click Insert. Now, once your image is inserted into Word, you'll find you can't move it. It will just keep clicking back to its original position. So there's one of two things you can do. You can either select it, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down, and you can select from any of these, but I tend to select In Front of Text. And now you can move this anywhere. Alternatively, you can just right click on your image and do exactly the same, go down to Wrap Text, and then go down and select any of these choices. So now you're able to move your image any way you like. We can now make some customizations. So you might want to crop your image, and in order to do so, select it, go to Picture Format, and go along to this icon here and click on the drop down. Now you can crop it to your own specification, or you can crop to a shape, or you can crop to an aspect ratio. So let's just try the crop at the top first. Once you've selected crop, you'll see the black markers around the outside, and you can either drag in the sides like this, or the top and bottom, or you can just use the corners to crop to your own specification. Once you've finished, you can just hit the return key and your image will be cropped. Alternatively, you can go up to the crop tool, you can go to aspect ratio, and you can click, let's say 1:1, because we want a square. And again, we can move the photograph left and right. But if we want to change it, if I just click on the corner and move it, it's going to lose its aspect ratio. So it will lose that 1:1 ratio. So in order to keep it, you have to click and hold down your shift key. And once you do that, it will keep that aspect. It doesn't matter where my cursor goes, it will keep that square aspect ratio. And then you can just press return. Now, when you are cropping to a shape, you need to be aware of the original crop of your image. And the reason I say that, if we just go back, if I want to crop this to a circle, because it's a rectangle, it won't crop to a circle, and I'll show you. If you go to the crop tool, go to shape, and you click circle, because your image is a rectangle, it will crop an oval. So in order to get a perfect circle, you first have to crop to a 1:1 ratio, press enter, then go to crop and crop to shape, and then crop to a circle, and then you'll have a perfect circle. And that will happen regardless of any image that you're using. You can also do that with other shapes as well, and just be aware again, the triangles and any of these circle objects, it will apply to the same. So if I try to crop to this one, it will do exactly the same, and you'll find yourself with an oval. Again, with the triangles, that also happens as well. If you want a perfect triangle, then again, crop to a square. So I'm just going to crop this to 1:1 ratio, hit my shift key, then I can move that around and then just click enter. The next thing I can do is make some alterations. So if I select the image, go to Picture Format, and if I go over here, you can see there are these four icons. The first one, corrections, you can see how I can increase the brightness and the contrast of my image if I'm not quite happy with it. And I can click on any of these to make those adjustments. I can also do that with color. If I click on the drop down, you can see I can also alter the color of my image. I can choose black and white, I can choose any of these sepias. And if you go down to the bottom here, there's also more variations. So I could click on green, and then obviously my image will have a green tone to it. If you want to go back, just press Command or Control Z, and you'll go back one step. You can also go to the artistic effects, and this will give you the effect of a painting or a drawing, a pixelation, and you can simply click through those and have a go and see if there's something there that you would like or prefer. The next one is transparency. If you go down to transparency and you want your picture as a background, you can simply select a particular transparency and then you can use that for a background and you can write on top of it. Now, if you want to write on top of a picture, the best way to do it is go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down, Draw Text Box, click and drag out your text box, just enter in some text. You can see we've got this white box here with a black background, which we don't want, so just select it, go to Shape Format, go over to this icon here, which is the outline, the black outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline, then go to Shape Fill here, click on the drop down and select No Fill, and now you can just resize this box and then you can move this text anywhere you like over your image. Now, if I move my image, you can see my text doesn't move. So once you've customized them both, let's just increase the size of this a little bit. I'm just going to go up to the Home tab and use the Increase Font Size tool. Once you're happy with where they both are, if you select them both, and to do that, select one of them, hold down your Command or Control key and select the other one. Go to Picture Format, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And now you can move them both at the same time. Unfortunately, you won't be able to resize them as a group. So if I try to do that, look at the text, what happens to the text. So you will have to ungroup them first before you're able to do that. To duplicate an image, or let's have two images and look at alignment. To duplicate, just select the image, hold down your Alt or Option key, click and drag, and it will duplicate that image for you. And then if we just misalign them, I'm going to show you how to align these images. Again, what we need to do is to hold down the Command or Control key while we select both images, go to Picture Format, go along to this alignment tool here and click on the alignment. If I want to align them to the left margin, that's this one. If I want to line them up both to the middle, I can select this one. So let's select that one. And what that will do is align all of these boxes, these central boxes, together to make them align to the center. If you want them aligned to the center of your page, you'll have to group them together first. So go to Group and select Group. So now this is one group. Then you can go back to Align, click on the drop down, and you can go to Align to Center, and it will align that to the center of your page. The same will go for if we just zoom out, if we want it to the center of our page vertically as well, go back to Picture Format, Align, and if you select Align to Middle, it will make sure that that's lined up top to bottom as well. So those two images are now perfectly lined up in the center of the page. Now it comes to aligning your image to text. I'm just going to put some text in. It's all to do with the wrapping. So at the moment we've selected in front of text. If I select this image, go to Picture Format, go to Wrapping, click on the drop down, and this is all of your wrapping. So at the moment we're in front of the text, we're on top of it. We can go behind the text, which as you can see, it disappears behind our text. We can select the top and the bottom, where whenever we move this image, the text will be at the top and the bottom of our image. Likewise, we can go to the through, which is very similar to tight, which means when we move our image around, the text is very tight to the edge of our image. And again, tight is very much the same, and square, again, that's a very similar technique. Now, what you will notice, now, as you can see, the text is very close to our image. So we can make adjustments to that very simply and make those spaces much bigger by selecting the image, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down. and go down to more layout options. Now you'll be in advanced layout, go to text wrapping and then go down to the bottom here and it says distance from text. You can make adjustments to those margins. So let's put all these to 1 centimeter because I think that's quite a good distance and then click OK. So you can now see that my text is much further away from my image and much more pleasing to the eye. Again, you can go back and make various adjustments if you want those further or closer together. It's completely up to you. But in terms of where the text lies, there's one more thing that you can do, which is slightly more quirky. If you select the image, go to wrap text, click on the drop down and go to this icon here and says edit wrap boundary. When you do that, you can see you've got this red line with these black boxes around the edge. I can now pull and push these markers and that will push away the text. So if I just deselect, you can see how it will push that text away to where I've made these boundary lines. And if I click away, you can see the effect that that has. Now you may have cause to use this, you may not, but I'm just showing you that that facility is here. If you don't like it, go back, Command or Control Z, and once again, and it will all return back to the original. If you want to lock this image in position, because obviously when you start typing, things begin to move around, select it, go to picture format, go to wrap text, and go to fix position on page. And once you do that, I can hit the return key, and my image will remain exactly where it is and will not move with the rest of my text. If you want a borderline around your image, select it, go to picture format, go to picture border, click on the drop down and select any color of your choice. Or you can go down to more outline colors. If you click on that, then we've got the color wheel. Let's just select a color. There we go. We've got the color wheel. You can move this little cursor around, select any color of your choice. Let's select a darker blue. Your color will appear here and then just click OK. Now if I deselect this, I'm just going to zoom in because you can't see this border very well, but I will make it bigger. You can just see a borderline around the edge of your image. So I'm going to select it again, go to picture format, and when I click on picture border, there's another option here at the bottom that says weight. I can go all the way down, let's select 6, and you can see now how I've got that border around the edge of my image. Now there are also lots of other things that you can do with this image, but if I double click on it, you can see there's another menu that appears over here. Now if you can't access that menu for some reason, go to picture format, go all the way over to format pane and click on that, and this menu will appear. If you go to the bucket icon, go down to line, this is exactly the same as we have just done with the border. This refers to the line around the outside of your image. So it's just another way of doing it. You can also put a gradient line around the outside and these sliders here would dictate what that gradient looks like. And all these markers, you can change the color or you can increase them or decrease them. So if I select this one, I'm going to take these 4 down to 2. So I'm going to select this one. I'm going to go to this remove gradient stop minus and this one as well minus. So I'm going to get rid of those 2. Select this one, click on the drop down, I'm going to select red, and then click on this one, click on color, and select orange. And now you can see the effect that gradient has. But furthermore, you can move these sliders to affect that gradient. So I have more red, or I can go the other way and select more orange. Again, completely up to you. So that's another thing that you can do with your images. You can also change the borderline to something a bit more drawn, a bit more wiggly. It's completely up to you. It's quite fun having a play around with them. And then there's also these lines as well where you can double up the lines. Let's just deselect that so you can see what the effect is. Reselect it again. And then if we don't want a line at all, we can just select no line. We can also go to this aspect here, which is effects. And in here we can go to shadow. We can put a shadow behind our image, just click on this icon here, just select one of your choice. You can see we've now got a shadow behind our image and you can make a variety of adjustments with these sliders. So you can change the size of that shadow, you can change the blur on it and you can change the distance and really fully customize that shadow. You can also go and play with all of the rest of these, and these literally are just a click and play. You can go to this icon here, and this again is all your picture corrections that we talked about earlier, and you can change the saturation of your image and use all of these sliders, your temperature control on your image as well. So this one is just far more customizable if you wanted to go ahead and do that as well. Your brightness and contrast slider over here, and also the sharpness you can adjust if you want it a little bit more blurry or a bit sharper. You've got the presets here that we talked about earlier, and you can go ahead and use those, or you can use the sliders, completely up to you. Again, you've got picture transparency and crop as well. So you can do so much with images in Word. It's really quite versatile. So go ahead and have a play. If you've got any issues, do comment below. I do try to respond to as many as possible. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.